So good morning, Joy Nostalg. Welcome to Wellness Wednesday. I'm happy and excited to be back here with all of you. And for this morning, we have a special guest. He's no stranger to our organization. His name is Father Bill Kreutz from Loyola House of Studies in the Ateneo de Manila University. And he's here to give us an Easter recollection. Jesus gives the gift of peace. So without further ado, let's all welcome Father Bill Kreutz. Good morning, Father Bill.
Good morning. Good morning, Jello. And good morning to all the friends from JNC. I'm happy to be here with you for this special Easter recollection. Basically, for me, a recollection is not a set of talks. It's really an attempt to pray a little better, to hear God's word, to reflect, and to respond. So it's not just hearing, but what do I do? How do I move after I've heard God's word? So today, what we'll do is we'll use pictures, the word of God, some input, and some quiet prayer. We'll have about three sections, just so you know ahead of time. One about Mary of Magdala, one about the men to Emmaus, and the third is going to be a local Philippine one. And then at the very end, for about the last 15 minutes of our hour, will be a time for a few people to share. We're going to start with the beautiful picture and with the song. You'll hear the song and you'll understand the words. Jello, the picture and the song, please.
Shall his justice in Christ my Savior, let all glory be. My heart, I know my Savior lives. I can hear him calling tenderly my name. For sin and death he has prevailed. In his glory, in his new life we partake. In my heart, I know my Savior lives. In his glory, in his new life we partake.
Our picture is at the tomb. Mary is sitting crying, and we hear the story.
We will now have our first reader, Miss Ella Faustina.
A reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 11 to 18. Early that Sunday morning, after the death and burial of Jesus, some women went to the tomb early in the morning to properly prepare the body of Jesus. To their amazement, they found the tomb empty. They found that the tomb was empty, and so they ran to tell the apostles. But Mary stayed outside the tomb weeping, and as she wept, she bent over into the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet where the body of Jesus had been. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken my Lord. I don't know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and your Father and to my God and to your God." Mary of Magdala went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and what he told her, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our first image today is a very beautiful story of the early morning. Mary is there, like all of us, hoping for the best, but not knowing what was going on. She wanted to get the body of Jesus, but actually, Jesus would call her by name. Of course, he didn't use the word Mary. The name is Miriam. That was the old Aramaic for Mary. A very popular name at that time. Very popular. So Miriam, right away she recognized him. I thought today we could start by ourselves letting Jesus talk to us, listen to what he has to say to us, asking him to call our name. I think that's a little important. Jesus, call my name. And then you can call back teacher, Ramoni, or Jesus. The whole thought is to look at the picture. See Mary weeping. Imagine if you were the one. That's the whole point. Imagine you are the one. How do you handle this story? So my thought is, put everything aside. You have a coffee cup, put it down. A bottle of water, put it down. Be seated quietly. Look at that picture. Look at the picture. Mary weeping because she's so disappointed. But I want to say that the whole role of Jesus is to bring peace and blessing. blessing. That's the role of Jesus in the resurrected world, to bring peace and blessing. And he does that first there with Mary. So she understands that. But my question is, of course, the biblical for us is, do we bring peace and blessing to others? When people see us, do they get afraid? Do they get upset? Or are they happy? And when we see people, do we give them a blessing? Do we say peace? Or do we ignore them? Turn them back. The Lord came to give us peace and blessing. So the question is, can we do the same? The first item of Jesus is to comfort others. Or we comfort people when someone dies. But comfort can be as simple as good morning. How is the day? How is your son, your brother? How is your papa? How are things going at work these days? All the nice things to say that pick people up. That's how you comfort. That's how you bring the good news of Jesus to others. You pick them up. That's what Jesus did for Mary. Can you do the same? Can you do the same? Can you pick up others in the workplace, a customer, a member of the family, a household bell? Can you pick up others? So what we'll do is we want to take time to think and pray. So the picture is on the screen. What would you be if you were Mary? What would you want to say? What do you want to say to Jesus? How do you want to live your new life in his glory, in his resurrection? So we'll take a few moments now for silent prayer. I pray, Lord Jesus, please come to me. Please take care of me and my family. Lord Jesus, today, especially I ask, help me to bring peace and comfort to others, like you bring peace and comfort to me. Help me, Jesus, to bring good news to others. I know my Savior lives. I know my Savior lives. Thank you, Jesus, for the resurrection. And in a very special way, thank you for going to Mary of Magdala. And thank you all these years that you have been with me. Help me in turn to bless and bring your good news to others. We pray. Jello, will you please spotlight me? Hello? Jello?
Father.
Will you please spotlight me?
Father, you are spotlight. Yes, Father.
Oh, thank you. Hello. Our first reading set the mood early that morning when the women went and Mary stayed and Jesus appeared. And they ran to tell the apostles. The second story I have today, all occurring the same day, is a beautiful story of two men feeling so bad and having to go on an errand. And this story of the trip to Emmaus. The picture is a beautiful picture, two men walking, but let's hear the amazing thing that happened as they walked along the road on the way to Emmaus. The picture, please.
We will now have our second reading by Sir Toby Cabrera.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, verses 13 to 35. Now that very day, two of them were going to a village 7 miles from Jerusalem called Emmaus, and they were conversing about all the things that had occurred. And it happened that while they were conversing and debating, Jesus himself drew near and walked with them, but their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped, looking downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, said to him in reply, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know of the things that have taken place there in these days?" And he replied to them, "What sort of things?" They said to him, "The things that have happened to Jesus the Nazarene, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people. How our chief priests and rulers both handed him over to a sentence of death and crucified him. But we were hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. And besides all this, it is now the third day since he took place. Some women from our group, however, have astounded us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. They came back and reported that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who announced that he was alive. Then some of us those with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had described, but him they did not see. And he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all the prophets spoke. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and enter into his glory?' Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all the scriptures."
Thank you, Toby. So that first part of the story, they're just walking by themselves. But they're kind enough when the stranger comes and he joins their conversation and they join along with him. Very, very nice. Very, very nice. They're very kind. They're open to others sharing their lives and their problems and their hopes. The second part of the story, continuing, really tells us an extraordinary thing that would occur next. So if you could have a book for us, and Toby, if you could do the reading, please.
Yes, Father. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave him the impression that he was going on farther. But they urged him, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening and the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. And it happened that while he was with them at the table, he took bread, said the blessings, broke it, and gave it to them, with that their eyes were opened and they recognized him. But he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Were are not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us?" So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them, who were saying, "The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon." Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So the picture is there. This is from a painting by the famous cartoonist Rembrandt. But notice they're sitting at a table. There's a waiter you can see a little on the right side there. And Jesus, as it was the custom in those days, someone picked up the bread. It was a big piece of bread there. It wasn't panimanicano, huh? It was more like a loaf of bread that was unopened, or maybe a little more like pita bread today. But he picks it up as they did. And they always said a blessing like we say today. We say, bless us, O Lord. But then he breaks the bread. He breaks it into pieces to give each of them a piece. And right away, they're amazed. They knew how Jesus broke bread. What would it be to be there yourself? I think when I look at this particular story, maybe the key element of the story was the invitation given by the two men. What was that invitation? Remember Jesus said, I've got to go on and going somewhere else. And they say, stay with us. Stay with us. I remember a retreat many years ago. That was my prayer for the whole retreat. Stay with me, Lord, stay with me. So here it is, stay with us. Stay with us. Feeding the stranger. Come and join us for the meal. You know, I thought about this very much yesterday when I heard wonderful news about community pantries. That in many parts of the city and throughout the nation, people are putting up small community pantries. Give as much as you can, take whatever you need. So people can go and get food. Maybe it's canned, maybe it's a piece of cabbage with folio, maybe it's tomatoes, maybe it's a can of sardines. But people are putting food out and people are coming who have no money. I have friends who have no job now, no job. Before they were construction. They were cleaning. A friend of mine worked in Gold's Gym. Gold's Gym is closed. Where does he get the money to feed the family? So community kitchens are a way that people take care of others, feed others, share with others. I wonder, does your community have a community kitchen, one or two or three? Here at the Nail, I heard there's one nearby on Katipunan Road at the place of the barangay. I know there's one in UP Teachers Village where it first began, the same Miss Norma. So many people now opening up, sharing what they have. How about you? Can you say, come, eat here, I'll put some food out for you? And you say, stay with me, as they say. So what we'll do is this. We'll take some quiet moments now. Each of us close your eyes or look at the picture and say that you would want to be there with Jesus. You want to be with Jesus in that picture. How would you feel? What would you want to say to Jesus? Jesus broke the bread. He broke the bread when he fed the hungry people, the 4,000 and 5,000. He broke the bread at the Last Supper. He broke the bread at Emmaus. And breaking the bread was a way to talk about sharing the Lord in the Acts of the Apostles. Sadly, at the moment, we can't share the Holy Communion. So pray now to receive the body and blood of Jesus. Pray for that gift at this moment. Jesus, stay with us. Help us out in moments of difficulty when we're not sure. Help us out when we feel afraid. But stay with us, Lord, stay with us. Help us to believe and trust in you no matter what. Thank you for breaking the bread with us and for us. Thank you for the breaking of the bread. Could I get spotlight, please?
Yes, Father.
Well, we've thought about two beautiful resurrection stories. Mary of Magdala there at the tomb, and the disciples on the way to Emmaus. The gospel stories are very beautiful. And by the way, may I add, these days the stories in the Acts of the Apostles. Read the Acts of the Apostles, read a half a chapter every day. They're beautiful stories about the early church, how people went about trying to bring good news, blessing to others, how it was received. I find it so invigorating and alive. I wish I understood it many years ago when I was younger. Read it now, but don't read it like you're reading a novel. Read it. This is an experience of the early church. For our last segment now, we go to something very, very familiar. St. Ignatius of Loyola, in his spiritual exercise, his retreat, has this as the first item. Can we show the picture, please, and let's hear what has to be said.
Our third reader is Ms. Kat Tolentino.
Traditional Philippine Easter Sunday morning celebration. Very early in the morning, the two statues of Jesus and Mary are carried in procession. Men walk in procession with the image of Jesus, and the woman in procession with the image of Mary, who is wearing a black veil. The processions begin in different parts of the parish. All are carrying candles. As the statues of Jesus and Mary meet in front of the church, a child, dressed as an angel, is lowered from a makeshift arch. The child, the angel, pulls off the black mourning veil of Mary. There are great shouts of joy. The church bells ring out. The choir and all sing out, Regina Celi.
Can we have the song Regina Celi right now? Is that possible?
First, Father.
Yes, let's have the picture and we'll sing the song.
The following version of Regina Celi is in Filipino and is something very familiar across many parishes.
Thank you.
When I came to the Philippines so many years ago, this was a whole new something for me. I didn't know anything about this custom or this tradition of the salubong. And then later on, as a priest, I used it in the chaplain Bagong Silangan, in Constitution Hill, here in the Ateneo, in the quadrangle where we had our Easter Mass. Wherever we would be, we would have the salubong. It was so special. Mary and Jesus meeting. Amazing. Amazing. There was a great deal of fun and joy and shouting because they met. That was not part of my childhood. My childhood never knew about that. But was part of an old Spanish tradition. Saint Ignatius said, who else would a boy appear to first other than his mother? And that's true. He would appear first to his mother, of course. Siempre. That's what I liked. I was amazed. So I was so joyful that Jesus first goes to his mother. It's not in the scripture. It's in the heart. Okay? Not in the scripture, but in the heart. In the human heart that looked for blessing from God. So what we'll do is now, we'll leave the picture the salubong there, and I want you to pray quietly. What would you say? What would you feel if you were there at that moment, the moment when Jesus meets his mother? What would they do? What would he say to her? What would she say to him? Think about that and just ask Jesus to bless you for a few moments. In Jerusalem, Mary is probably by herself, or maybe with some others. She's still the sorrowful mother that Sunday morning. She does not know yet. And then all of a sudden, the Son appears, all of a sudden. For sure, they embrace. Mary's heart, which has been pierced by a sword, is now glorified by Jesus as your son. What would you want to say to Mary? What would you want to say to Jesus? Comfort them, make them happy, be at peace. You remember, Mary, that Jesus was so good to come to you. Help us to bring blessing to others, especially those who are sorrowing because of the COVID, those who are sorrowing because there's not enough food or whatever in the household. Mary, please help us. Ask Jesus to visit us. Take care of us. We'll end this segment. Can I invite you to please pray with me the words from the Holy Scriptures, the words that we pray together to Mother Mary. Let's pray together. Hail Mary, full of grace. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We'll end now for a short time. I think we're going to get a response by a few people before we have our final prayer and blessing. So, Yolo, are there some people who are going to share for a few moments?
Yes, Father Bill, there are some. But for that, Father, thank you for the beautiful reflection. And I'm sure our panelists here will have some insights to share. So perhaps we can begin first with our with one of our readers, Miss Ella Faustino. Good morning, Miss Ella. Miss Ella is a housekeeping officer from the Hospitality Development Unit in the hotel. So good morning, Miss Ella. Welcome.
Good morning, Sir Jello. Good morning, Father. Father,
morning.
Thank you for the message for today. It was very uplifting. With all that's happening to the world right now with the COVID, I was just really struck with this message that the resurrection, the death and the resurrection of the Lord just really bring comfort to all of us right now, despite the mourning, the anxiety. Thank you for sharing us that that despite of all the things that's happening, we can still be a blessing in trusting God, and that we can only find refuge to the Lord in times like this. Father, thank you.
Good, Ella. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Ella. I like how she pointed out that we can still continue to be blessings, right, to other people despite that. That are happening around us. So thank you so much for that, Miss Ella.
Thank you.
And one of our readers, Miss Kat. Miss Kat is an officer from the Resource Management Unit. Hi, Miss Kat. Good morning.
Hi, sir. Hi, Father Bia.
Good morning.
So I just want to share my insights from what I've learned from Father Bill. I just realized that before I used to invite Jesus into my heart all the time, and yet I never had any peace. Then I could not understand my problem until God showed me that the very fact that that I was inviting Jesus into my heart all the time was an indication that I really had not trusted Jesus to do what I had asked him to do. So my testimony is my life really changed when I prayed one night and said, Jesus, I have repented of my sins. I have asked you to save me. I now trust you to do what I have asked you to do. When I started trusting Jesus, my life really changed. Peace flooded my soul. So that's when I learned a wonderful Bible lesson. So it's like, this is a result of trusting Jesus always.
Yes.
I think Mary at the tomb had trust. She just wasn't sure. I wonder about Mama Mary. But yeah, thank you for that. Yeah, the prayer of trust, even when we're not sure. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Miss Ella and Miss Kat. So, Father, perhaps you could proceed with the final question.
Okay, well, how about a few words from you, Jello?
Oh, thank you, Father Bill. Well, I really loved during the recollection how we got the chance to imagine ourselves in those specific scenarios. It was very refreshing for me and very joyful for me to see myself with Jesus, you know, with his mother Mary in that scene. And just to imagine the kind of emotions that went on between them, you know, for a mother to see her son, who she willingly, you know, let go to undergo all the passion and the sacrifice, and it just goes to show the kind of the kind of sacrifices we too are capable of making and the joy we can bring to other people. You know, so thank you for that, Father.
Well, as we end,
just
a final few odds and ends. Do you mind? Number one, I think you have been here before, but this is sort of a little prayer and mass corner in my own room at the seminary. And of course, on the top is the cross of San Damiano from the chapel of St. Francis of Assisi in Italy. On the your left side is, the, of course, the Paschal candle, which for us is the symbol of the risen Lord. It's just a symbol, but it's alive. The candle is lit. That's why I have a candle here. I like candles. So the candle is there. Then on the left side, your right side, is the image of the hands of Jesus. Well, Thomas, remember the reading 2 weeks ago, and a half ago? See my hands and my feet. And Thomas says, my Lord and my God. I got these pictures. These are in Google Images. You can find them yourself and put it on your screen for prayer. I find pictures a very big help for me. When I pray at this area because of the pictures. The pictures help me focus my thinking and my prayer. And I think that's really important. I want to end this day by just underlining the major idea here is that the risen Jesus comes to comfort and to bring peace. And if you want to judge your own life, how well you're doing, that's a good question. Do I bring comfort and peace to others? And that's the prayer you want. I want to do this. When I think something bad, I must change it to something good. When I think of putting someone down, I want to think of a way to when someone hurts me, I want to be forgiving right away and then find a way to be kind. It's a change. It's a change. But that's the whole point. Jesus died on the cross on Good Friday, and yet on Sunday, he's risen. It can happen. God's grace is much bigger than we can imagine. So please, maybe take these. Now, I've mentioned already to Jello that if you want a copy of these pictures and the readings, just see him and he can email something to you somehow or other. But it's all written up and he has it and he can send it on to you, your computer, whatever you would like that. But I like pictures. I like stories that have pictures. But these three pictures are important. Can we flash the picture, the first one again, Jello? Is that possible?
Sure, Father. Hold on.
Okay. Yes. Say when.
This image.
Okay. Here's the, that, there it is. Mary is there crying and Jesus is there. Mary. Miriam, please, it's okay. And she just grabs him. She just grabs him. That's nice to pray about. Pray about that. Can we go to the image of them sharing the meal, please?
Here, Father.
Well, there they are. What would it be? Would you say, hey, stay with us. Take merienda with us. Have a dinner with us. Join us for a cook, whatever it is. But know that when you say to others, come, you're saying to Jesus, come. There is a very old statement that said, when a guest comes, it's Jesus who comes. And maybe make your little prayer, your mantra, stay with me, Lord. Stay with me, Lord. Boy, fabulous. But that picture will help you. Notice that because you invited him, he breaks the bread and gives you part of the bread. The Eucharist for us is prefigured there. That's how we knew he broke the bread. That's what the priest does at Mass. He still breaks the bread. So that's one. Can we go to the third picture, please? The picture of the salubong.
Let's hear your father.
Okay. Well, we'll end with this picture. This is just a great picture. I don't know where it happened. Yeah, I got this on Google also. But there they are in front of a church. I've been at this. I've been involved. It's tremendous. Tremendous. I remember doing it in Zamboanga. We were at the leper colony where we offered mass regularly. And the processions would come from different parts, the women and the men. And the singing. And then that beautiful Tagalog version of the Regina chanting. Beautiful. So use these. Use these to keep your spirit going. Don't let the day end today. Let the day continue. Let the Lord be present for you and make him present for others. Now what we'll do is we'll have a prayer and a blessing. And then after that, our final song. The final song is Shine, Jesus, Shine. And so I want you to sing that out too. We want Jesus to shine in our lives. That's the gift we need and we want. Shine, Jesus, shine. So first of all, a prayer and a blessing for you and your families and our world. So Lord, please be with us today. Bless us these holy Easter days. Keep us close to you. Call us by name. Give to us the grace to invite you into our hearts so you may break the bread with us, that we might know you love us. And give to us the great joy of meeting with Mary, your mother. Thank you so much for today, for the blessings that you share with us. And Lord, help us to share blessing and peace and joy and comfort, especially to the many who are sick, to the people of Myanmar, to those who are in trouble in other parts of the world who are suffering so much. Help us bring to us peace which we need. But bless us all these Easter days. So I ask the Lord to bless you. Please bow your head. May the Lord who gives to us life, the Lord Jesus who gives to us death and resurrection, and the Holy Spirit that fills us to carry out the message of Jesus, may he bless you, Father and Son and Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear friends, it's been good to be with you. I'm happy to be here. Thank you, Jello, and thanks to Mr. JNC and to the whole community of the companies. Let us join together. We're going to sing Shine, Jesus, Shine.
Okay, I will now share the video.
Okay, thank you. Please join in song.
Jesus, light of the world, shine upon.
Very much, Cello. Really good. Blessings for all.
Thank you so much, Father Bill. And also, thank you for everyone who joined us this morning. I just posted the attendance sheet in the chat box, so please fill it up. So thank you, everyone, and thank you, Father Bill.